Hello everyone, good day to all. I welcome all Maria kids to today's online live classes. I am Pushpashri, faculty of Bhatt and Bhatt Tutorials. I'll be handling mathematics for Navodaya, Sainik as well as RMS school entrance exam. So well Maria kids, in the last session we were discussing about the chapter of fraction. And there we have solved some of the problems. And if you people have missed the last session, please go through the description box and watch the previous class videos. And well, let us start today's class. Let us continue the problems from today's session. So let us move on with the eighth problem for today. The problem is like this. A man earns rupees 15,000 in a month, full stop and continue, in a month and spends two by third of his earnings per month, full stop and continue. Calculate his yearly savings. So this is your question. See to the question first. There is a man and he is going to earn 15,000 for 1 month. That means a man's salary is 15,000 for a month. And in that 15,000, the man is expenditure. That means he is going to spend two-thirds out of 15,000. Two-thirds part will be spent. Two-thirds and his earnings per month. And spends two-thirds part of his earnings per month. So whatever the 15,000 he is going to get, with that, in that two by third he is going to spend for his expenses, then what is this yearly savings? So if he is spending some money and in the meanwhile he will be keeping some money in the form of savings, so how much is that savings when you calculate for the whole year? So that one you have to find out here. So we'll move on with the solution. Expenditure is nothing but the spendings, which is equal to two-thirds will be spent out of 15,000. Correct. 3 ones are 3 fives are 1, 2, 3. So 5 twos are, it is how much? 10,000. So 10,000 rupees is a saving of per month. Okay. So therefore monthly savings is equal to 15,000 he will get. So out of 15,000 he is going to spend 10,000 and the remaining will be 5,000 will be there in his hand. That means as a saving. Therefore, so I can tell that yearly savings is equal to, if 5,000 is there for per month, we have 12 months nearly. So 12 into 5,000, 12 fives are, it is 60. Rupees 60,000 is the savings per year. Copy down this now. Fine, hope you all copied this. I'll move on with the ninth problem now. Problem number 9. So we'll see to the next problem. So problem number 9. The question is like this. If x is equal to 3, comma, y is equal to 4, comma, z is equal to 5, full stop and continue. Find the value of, in the bracket you have to write x plus y plus z, close the bracket, divided by x, y, z into 5. Okay, so this a bit different is that here. See to the solution. X value is 3, y value is 4, z value is 5, and you have to find the value of x plus y plus z into 5 and the whole divided by x, y, z. So easiest problem, in the place of x put the value of x, in the place of y put the value of y, and in the place of z put the value of z. So that they are telling that x plus y plus z plus 5, the whole divided by x, sorry, this is into, okay, multiplication, whole divided by x, y, z. So x is 3 plus 4 plus 5 into 5, the whole divided by 3 into 4 into 5. And 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 into 5 divided by 4 threes are 12. 12 fives are 60. So 12 fives are 60 divided by 60. 60 ones are 1. So along with that, I'll solve one more problem. You can see to that. So you can write both the problems together. So they are telling that arrange the fraction 21 by 42, comma 14 by 42, comma 30 by 42 in descending order. So this is your question where you have to arrange the numbers in the descending order. So here, as you see in the question, all the numbers denominators are same, directly we can go. But in previous problems, denominator values were different, so we found it out the LCM. But here, no need to find the LCM, go with directly. Descending means it is from highest to lowest, that is descending order. Descending order is equal to 30 by 42, comma 21 by 42, comma 14 by 42. So this is your answer. Copy down this now. Fine. Hope you copied these two problems now. So now I'll go with the next problem. That is your problem number 11. So now I'll go with the 11th problem. See to the question. So the 11th question is like this. Okay, the question number 11. So the question is like this. The product, I read 3 by 8 of a 3 by 8 of a book on one day, book on one day, full stop and continue, and 4 by 5th of the reminder on another day. On another day, full stop and continue. If there were 30 pages unread, comma, how many pages the book contain? How many pages the book contain? So what they are asking in the question, see and understand it first. So read the question once. I am going to read 3 by 8 of a book on one day. So on one day I am going to complete 3 by 8th part of the book, and 4 by 5th reminder in the another day I am going to read. And if there were 30 pages unread, still if you read today and tomorrow, still you have a pages left. How many pages does the whole book is going to contain? You have to see to it. So let the total number of page be 1. So since we don't know, so we are naming that as let the number of pages be 1. That means, see here, 1/3/8, 4/5. So all it contains 1, right? So that's the reason we are taking it as 1 in the beginning. So number of pages read on the day, number of pages can be reached in one day. So in one day, how many pages can we read? As they are telling, 3/8. So which is equal to 3/8 page. And what is the remaining page now? Remaining page. So to know that remaining page, what we have to do? 1 - 3/8. So we have named the number of pages be 1, right? So 1 minus per day, how much you will read? 3/8 part you will read. And what is the remaining part? That is 5/8. Ma'am, have you got 5/8? If nothing is here, denominator will be 1. Take the LCM for 8 and 1. So when you take the LCM will be 8 itself. Take the first part of the fraction, 1/1 into 8. 1 ones are 1 eights are, 8 ones are 8. Take the second part of the fraction, 3/8 into 8. So 3 ones are 3. So 8 minus 3, so that is 5/8. Got this now? So now, total number of pages read. Total number of pages. How many pages that the man has read? So we'll see to that. So now we got to know remaining pages and in one day how much he will read. So with that information, we can find out the number of pages read on another day. Another day is here. The number of pages read on another day. So another day, how many pages that he is reading? So that is 4/5 part he is reading, correct? So the number of pages that he is reading on the other day is 4/5 part. So now with these two information, we can find out the total number of pages that a man has read, which will be equal to, so in first day, 3/8 plus 1/2. 3/8 plus 1/2. Ma'am, have you got 1/2? So here, so the pages this he is read on another day is 4/5. And before that, he had already read 5 into 8. So together, so 4 ones are 4 twos are, 5 ones are 5 ones are, that is 1/2. Got this now? So 1/2 I had taken here. So now if you find the LCM for 8 and 2, so you can see here LCM for 8 and 2, this is all the working note, okay? So 8 and 2, 2 ones are, 2 fours are, 2 twos are 4, 1s are, so 2 1s are, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, divided by 8/3 into 8, so 3 1s are, it will be 3 only, 2 1s are, 2 4s are 8, 4 1s are 4, 3 plus 4, 7. So 7/8 is the total number of pages a man can read. So what are the remaining page left? Therefore, remaining page is equal to total pages 1 minus he has already read 7/8 part, that means 7/8 pages thus he has already read. So 1 minus 7/8 will be 1/8. Take the LCM again here and then do it, you will get 1/8. Therefore, total number of pages will be equal to 30 divided by 1 by 8, which will be equal to 30 into 8, that is 240. So 240 is your answer. Copy down this now. Fine, hope you all copied this. Now I'll go with the next problem, the 12th problem, problem number 12. So see to the 12th problem now, problem number 12. The problem is like this. The product of two fractions is 6. The product of two fractions. The product of two fractions is 6. Full stop and continue. If one fraction is 5 by 3, full stop and continue, find the other. What they are telling in the question, the product of two fractions is 6. So when you multiply, product of that two fraction will be 6, and in that, if one fraction is 5 by 3, what is the another? So since we don't know the fraction, so let the fraction be x. So since the fraction is x, then what, how it will become? X plus 5 by 3 is equal to 6. That means the product of two fraction is 6. That means when you multiply the two fraction, it will be 6. Okay. So when you multiply the two fraction, the product is 6. In that, one of the fraction is 5 by 3. What is the other fraction? You have to find it out. And to find it out that, so you can put into, or you can put 5x like that. So it's equal to 5 into x, 5x by 3 is equal to 6. So x is equal to 6 into 3. The cross multiplications we can do. 6 into 3 divided by 5. 6 threes are 18 by 5. So 18 by 5 is the answer. Copy down this now. Fine. Hope you all copied this. I'll move on with the 13th one now. Problem number 13. That is also easiest one. 13th problem. Find the value of, they have given like this. So in this, so you have two squared parts. Okay. So here it's been divided into four parts. In that, this part has been shaded. This part has been also shaded. And this part too. And there are two parts, remember? Okay. So there are two parts, and even this part has been shaded. Plus, put one triangle and put the line in the middle and the cross lines. Okay. And then here, this part has shaded, this part has been shaded. So now what you have to do, you have to find the value of this. Only this is the question. So how you will do the solution? So I have already explained in the theory, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, out of 8 parts, how many parts shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, that means 4 by 8, plus here, out of how many parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, out of 6 parts, the 2 part has been shaded. Then what is the value you have to find? And to find out what you will do, take the LCM for 8 and 6, 2 3s are, 2 4s are. Again, 2 2s are 4, 3 as it is, 2 1s are 3, and then 3 1s are. So now 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 3s are 24. So 24 is your LCM. So take the first part, that is 4 by 8 into 24. 4 3 is a, it is 12. Plus take the second part, 2 by 6 into 24. 6 4 is a 24, 2 4 is a, it is 8. So 18, 19, 20, 20 by 24. But here in your options, the options are like this. Option A 5 by 6, option B 4 by 6, option C 9 by 6, option D 7 by 6. So is that answer is visible over here? No. But still you can further divide, right? So 4 5s are 20, 4 6 are 24. So 5 by 6 is your answer. Option A is the correct answer. Go down this now.